So, this is the team we are going to start the first game against Ipswich with. It's a bit of a weird formation, but I'm going to try it anyway. I think we've got the players to make it work. Nowhere for Reed to go, really. Nice and easy. No need to rush. Oh, great ball! Oh, yes! There was no need to rush! But Armstrong and Bradley Dack have linked up after just 26 minutes of the first game. And it's one goal for Dack and 1-0 for Rovers. Yeah, Armstrong, he sees the move by Dack, and I thought the defender had that, to be fair. It's pretty poor defending. Corey Evans finding some space. Oh, he slipped Armstrong through. Surely now number two for Armstrong. What a pass by Corey Evans. What a celebration. He just splits the defenders. Look at that. That's awful defending again from Ipswich, really. And nice and easy to put it away for Armstrong. That's 2-0. Now, here we go. Charlie Mulgrew, ever dependent at the back to deal with the crumbs that have been left. Niambi now, cuts inside. Niambi, got a bit of space. Plays through to Big Ben. Big Ben for three. Debut goal for Ben Bretherton. And three for Rovers. And now it is game over for sure. Great to get Ben Bretherton off the mark early. And a nice debut goal for him. Keeper nearly got it. Probably should have got it, to be fair. Let's have a quick look at the stats. So 58% possession isn't exactly what I was hoping for. I was hoping for a little bit more, to be fair. Niambi, probably my man of the match and FIFA's man of the match. He was absolutely brilliant in this game. Assisted one goal. And he's just fantastic. So before we jump into the Millwall game, I just wanted to go over a couple of things that are happening behind the scenes. So we're desperately trying to get some loan time for Fisher. I must have accepted about 5 or 6 of them. And he's constantly saying no and rejecting them. So, but we've had offers for Richie Smallwood, one for Forest actually. Again, I've said no. Couple for Dak, a fairly decent price. I've said no. Benno, decent price for Benno, to be fair. I've said no. Offer for Conway, no. Samuel Lutwiler, and a loan offer for Joel Nutto, which I rejected. Basically, I want to keep the same team for this first window. I'm not going to be bringing anyone in. There's a couple of youth players that are younger players that are players that I'm not going to use, like Gladwin and Fisher, that I want to loan out. Something I'll try and get done between now and then. Let's get into Millwall. Another 3 points in league would be fantastic. So here we are, game two, our first home game of the season versus Millwall, and we are going with the exact same team as last game, as it served us fairly well, I would say, and a nice clean sheet and a 3-0 win. I don't know whether it's this defence or what, but we are defending very well, not just in this game, but in the last game. And Armstrong's through. Surely now. Yes, nice and easy. Slides it past the goalkeeper. And Armstrong's got his second of the season already. This season could go quite well. I mean, to be fair, we probably should have had a lot more than we've got. Well, we should have more than one. Some of the attacks that Armstrong street through on. Oh, great ball from Armstrong, and this has got to be Dak. Dak for two, surely. Nice, easy finish into the corner. Armstrong and Dak are becoming a partnership to remember, I suppose. I was trying to think of something better. Oh, dangerous from Benno. Finds a route out. That was great, great play. Bit sloppy, but got there in the end. Armstrong makes a turn, finds Bradley Dack. Bradley Dack, and oh, how has he missed it? Oh wow! I thought that was three. I actually nearly said, and that is three. So let's have a quick look. 12 shots, 9 on target, 54%. Again, kind of trying to. I want more. I want a higher percentage, if you know what I mean. In the game, Nyambi not as good as he was last game, but Armstrong with a 9.4. He only got one. Could have had so much more. 2 shots, 2 on target. So this is a team that will be playing in our first cup game of the season. It's the first round of the Carabao Cup against Pompey. Just maybe need to calm it down a little bit. There we go, nice move. Ben makes a move, great move from Ben Bretherton. Can he play it in? Danny Graham's surely going to finish from this angle, and yes he does. Side 1-0, and after some early pressure from Portsmouth, we take the lead and go 1-0 up in the cup game. Great link up play from Bretherton and Danny Graham. And you just felt that he wasn't going to miss from there. As you saw, I don't know whether you saw in that last shot, and it's the first time I've seen it, it's like the dynamic badges. You might see it from this angle. They actually have the Carabao Cup, and you can see it on the Portsmouth players, which I think is really cool there on Danny Graham. That's pretty cool. But yeah, 1-0. There we go. Brilliant header from Downing then to get the ball out. And there we go. Bretherton wins it back, makes a turn. Danny Graham has to come over and win this ball, and he does not win it. And the pressure is back on with Portsmouth. Can Rovers see this pressure? Oh, what a goal! What a fantastic goal from Portsmouth. They've been putting the pressure on. We haven't really been dealing with it too well. We've been giving possession away fairly easily, and that was an excellent goal. Then I think it was Dennis. Just look at this. We weren't dealing with it, and he was wide open. What a shot. Just swinging away from Raya. Raya's had to make some brilliant saves so far this season. This game. Oh, and I think that was Reed. Just so close to touching that ball, but Raya was not getting that. That was an excellent shot. Here we go. Back to 1-1. Danny Graham's actually looking like he's carrying an injury. Great ball from Rothwell. Samuel, can he get his first of the season? Yes, he can. Tucked it away into the far corner. And you always felt when he got into that position he was going to finish it. Little bit disappointed about Graham. Maybe he's injured. He had the injury sign over his head. He may have to come off. But yeah, this is great work from Rothwell. Samuel coming in from that right-hand side. And just knew he was going to tuck it away in that corner. Oh, Rothwell's been done. Portsmouth playing inside, but Raya has that nice and easily. We will launch a very dangerous and quick attack. There we go. Great ball over the top. Samuel down this right-hand side is going to cut in. Told you. Whips it in. Back post. Conway. 3-1. Great attack from Rovers. And from coming from having to save his shot. Got out fast. Great ball from, I'm not quite sure who it was, but if it was on the left-hand side, it would have been Downing, I think. Great ball right over the field to Samuel. Cuts back in, whips it into the back post where Conway's charging, smashing across the face of goal. Oh, bad. Downing's built fairly well at the back as well. As Rovers continue to move forward. Nice and easy. Not looking to rush anything right now. Cadlin. What can Cadlin do? Look at him move. Yes! And it's another goal! And I think, fairly sure that's Cadlin. Cadlin, I'm not even sure how you say his name, but he scored. It took a deflection, but I think he deserves one. He's played fairly well since he's come on. He made some good passes. Couple of good little shifty moves there. Whacked it against the defender and it just rebounds into the net. And the keeper didn't really know what the hell was going on. Right off his arm. And the keeper is gobsmacked. I think it's 3-1, 4-1, I've lost count. As I said, Portsmouth had a number of shots, only got 7 on target, but them 7 were really hit with no conviction and didn't really have any bite on it. I'm surprised that we had more possession than them because they were on the ball quite a lot. And 7 shots, 4 goals, and every goal that went on target went in. So yeah, great game. Quick look at the ratings. Samuel with a 9-1, and man of the match for him. I thought he was brilliant. Downing defended brilliantly as well. Davenport was great. Rothwell was really good. Conway was excellent. Yeah, it was a good game. Yeah, I'm excited. Let's get through to the next round, but that's it. That's all the games for this episode. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye!